Oh, hey, what's up, you little titty snakes? It's me, Erik, your teacher. Hey, anybody else having this same problem as me where, like, they haven't laughed in a really long time, like months? I remember the last time I laughed. It was back in March. It was a Friday. And it was to this video. Yeah, and then my cat got coronavirus and died. Well, you know what? Actually, I laughed when that happened too. So that was the last time I laughed. But still, that was a really long time ago. I gotta figure this out. Dude, you can hear his ass inhale at the beginning. Now do it on the cabin PA on the plane.
Did he suck air into his ass before letting out that bomb?
I'm literally crying from watching this.
I just watched this 4 times in a row and I'm still crying from laughing so hard.
Very nice video, guys. Good job. Very funny.
Next person who uses that phone gonna get pink eye.
My fucking face hurts from laughing. I'm foul.
I worked part-time for the library. I got kicked out for farting into the speaker for storm alerts, but a lot of people laughed really hard.
Yeah. Yeah, laugh it up, you pieces of shit. See if this comment doesn't bring you back down to earth.
Laughter and sadness. Such opposite emotions, yet both make us cry. Sadness gives us strength, while laughter refills our hope, what our hearts fight for. Once there was a man with no laughter or sadness. His name was Ted Cruz. He was a lizard, the kind that likes tweets of porn, plus his dick was weird. I have only heard tell of the one they call Ted Cruz. Sounds like a bitch, though. Real annoying voice, with a handicapped penis. Not a single friend. It doesn't matter. Ted Cruz has no emotions. He gets off to blood. I hope I never, never ever hear him laugh. Lest I lose my mind. I prefer him numb. May sadness never find him, so that laughter can't. Big money, I'm out. Suck my gross balls and asshole. Whole thing's a haiku.
And post! Oh, I saw that, Jeremy. You just laughed. Get the fuck out of here. This is for people who can't.
Ready to block someone.
Hey guys, I've been having a hard time laughing lately. Can one of you tell me a joke?
Women's rights.
Ah, cool. And Fortnite dance. Ah, shit. I hit the wrong button. Sorry, guys. Hang on. It's Fortnite dance. Ah, damn. My key bindings are all off. Well, anyway, I'm under no impression that I'm going to magically learn how to laugh again over the course of this lesson. But you know me. I'm one of those. It's all about the journey, not the destination type of guys. And plus, I got you along for the ride. And we always have fun together. Well, what's this? Kanye West is peeing on a Grammy? Well, that's got to be funny. Let's check that out. Ooh, yeah, you know what? I just feel bad for the guy watching this. There's nothing funny here, and even if I did make a joke, I'd probably get in a lot of trouble. So I should probably delete this tweet that I had here. I can't even tell if that was gonna be funny anyway. I don't know how to laugh.
Well, this was the best thing that happened to me all week.
Well, I'd say Twitter's out. That place fucking sucks. Maybe what I need is some good old-fashioned YouTube you laugh, you lose videos.
You laugh, you lose. Very good.
Well, this might be just what the doctor ordered before he collapsed from exhaustion and died because without him, the hospital was understaffed. And play. Yeah, I don't know, man. These were a lot funnier when I was younger.
Oh, wait.
Oh, shit, that person got really hurt. Oh, fuck. Oh, are they okay? Uh-oh, watch out. Oh, she smashed right into it.
Sorry.
This isn't funny. This is just people getting hurt.
I did not laugh at all.
I didn't laugh again for the 3rd time in a row. I don't know why I'm even doing these. This ain't funny anymore.
Bro, I didn't laugh.
Disappointing.
None of your videos are funny.
Well, for once, I agree with the comment section. This was not funny, and I'm going to leave my review thusly. Wow, I can't believe how much disturbing violence you included in your little laughter game. Like, what's going on here? Do you people J-O to this stuff or something? Because if you do, you're gonna love J-N-O's to my YouTube channel, Salvia Stunts. I crash my fucking bike into a garbage truck arm that picks me up and dumps me inside before compressing me to death. It's a total whoopsie, extremely sexy stuff. Also, check out my link tree where you can find all my pay pages where I'll send you personalized videos of me trying to ice skate for the first time and shattering my ankles before a sniper blows my head off. Salvia Stunts, check it out. I'm working on a video right now called You Laugh, You Bust a Fat One, and it's 100% injuries, including footage of a guy catching coronavirus just by visiting walmart.com. That's right, Walmart as a business has so much coronavirus inside it that just interacting with them online is enough to give you a viral load. Speaking of loads, I gotta go hurl myself off a waterfall and comically hit every rock on the way down so some dude in Utah can jizz to it. See ya, and post! Alright, well, I still haven't laughed yet, but it's not for lack of trying. And I will say it's a good thing that when Raycon approached me for today's sponsored sketch, I replied, well, hey, I want to make this kind of serious this time around. No jokes, no funny stuff. Just straight commercial. And they were like, oh great, no funny stuff, so you're not gonna put anything super weird in there? And I was like, of course not, just regular commercial. And they were like, all right, well, we trust you. And I still haven't sent them the cut of this sketch yet, but they trust me, so I'm just gonna play it.
Play.
Hello, today on the podcast, we're going to talk about the miraculous economic recovery of a small village in Rwanda. All thanks to one unexpected penguin. The United Democratic Forces was a coalition of Rwandan exile opposition groups with a large base of active members in...
Raycon's disconnected. Speaker.
Oh, no, I shit myself. I shit my pants. Oh, my pants are filled with shit. I'm a shitty little baby.
Pause. Play.
Oh, God damn it! I gotta throw out this chair for sure. It's all covered in shit. My shit. I shit on.
Pause. Raycon's paired. Play.
And when those glacial shelves eventually crashed into the ocean, it sent a single GPS-chipped penguin floating nearly 5,000 miles to Cape Town. That's where EP-124 became known as Archimedes.
Paused. Raycon's disconnected. Speaker.
Guys, bad news. I just shit myself again. Also, at the end of this story, the penguin dies. Gets flattened by a motorcycle.
Paused. Raycon's paired.
We don't know how Archimedes survived his trip, but what we do know is marine biologist and... Oh, hello.
Whoa. You're the guy from the podcast.
Well, I see you're listening on your everyday E25 earbuds. Excellent choice, and they're the sponsor of today's podcast.
Is that why every time I take my Raycons off, you shit yourself?
In terms of audio fidelity, yes. And if you go to buyraycon.com/bigmoney, you get 15% off your first order. And these little guys are already about half the price of other premium wireless earbuds, so I'd say it's quite the steal.
But they sound just as good as other top audio brands.
And that's why I love my everyday E25 earbuds, with their comfortable and discreet fit, noise isolation features, and up to 6 hours of playtime.
What's that beeping?
Holy shit, lady, your carbon monoxide detector's been going off this whole time. You need to get the hell out of here.
One second.
Raycon's disconnected.
Oh, I just filled my pants.
I just had to see it for myself. The difference in audio fidelity is so clear to me now.
Lady, you're dying from asphyxiation. You gotta get the hell out of here. Don't ever hallucinate me again. Anyway, back to Rwanda, Archimedes' new home after a long trip from Cape Town, but only 30 kilometers away from where Lucas Mahigo is buying his dream motorcycle.
Hey, buyraycon.com/bigmoney for 15% off your first order.
This is Talking Carl.
This is Talking Carl.
He repeats everything you say.
He repeats everything you say.
And he's gonna get in a fight.
And he's gonna get in a fight.
Ugh. My voice is higher than your voice.
My voice is higher than your voice.
Huh? Oh, hey, yeah, sorry, I thought we were still in the commercial. I'm just doing some reconnaissance here to see if maybe, like, it's silliness that'll make me laugh, but... I know this video's funny, and I can see why it's funny, but I just can't laugh at it. What is that? I don't understand. I'm gonna close this.
This is Big Bull Trick Shots!
What the...
They're playing bad!
Oh, all around.
Where am I? TikTok.
To the beach.
Right in the knuckles.
Whoa, what was that? That was like almost a laugh.
Ayo, hey, yeah. This one goes out to all the 65 plus crowd on SoundCloud.
TikTok is making me feel things. I convinced my best friend to go to war with me and I was the only one who returned. Sorry about that, buddy. Embarrassed emoji. I really miss Harold.
Yes! Come on, I'm so close. Oh, I'm so close, I can feel it.
Who told their grandpa to sit in front of the camera and move around and then put those words up there?
Anybody see his bio?
Wait, what's his bio? Made my account to make sure my granddaughter wasn't being a hoe. Watch out, Jess.
Oh, bless you, old man. Bless you.
You have to stop commenting daddy on all of my posts.
Dr. Phil's talking about people calling him daddy?
I appreciate the support. A little weird.
You're not a real doctor either, but you still put that in your name, so I'm gonna keep calling you daddy, bro. And send. Well, once again, the greatest generation comes to save the day, keeping comedy alive even in these dire times. Well, I think I've got a lot to learn from this app, and maybe, just maybe, I can learn to laugh again.
Wait, what?
Walmart to acquire 7.5% stake in TikTok.
Oh, that means it's gonna get cheap and shitty.
I got what you need. Woke up in the store again with
you. Oh, that's not funny. Oh, come on.
There's so many ways to love ya.
She's talking really negative. She's swearing.
And delete TikTok. God damn it. It was so good for a second there. I was this close to laughing, and then, like with everything else, children showed up and fucking ruined it for everybody. Fuck! Well, I did have one last thing that I wanted to try to see if it could get me to laugh, but it's not really my thing. Offensive humor? Funniest fucked up jokes ever!
There's something wrong with it. Like, I was thinking the other day that you can figure out how bad a person you are by how soon after September 11th you masturbated, like how long you waited. And for me, it was between the two buildings going down, so I have a feeling like...
Yes.
I mean, it was going on about the diving for some reason. It's not even a difficult dive! It's the same diving boat you get at decent swimming baths. 9/11, that was a difficult dive.
Huh? What? Can you tell what the fuck this guy's saying?
Apparently the Saudi Arabian Paralympic team is just thieves.
What the fuck is he saying?
Enjoyed the Levinson inquiry. I like the McCanns on there. I kept wanting them to go, could you round it up in the next 10 minutes, mate? We've left the kids over in Starbucks.
What? Anyway, I might not be able to laugh, but maybe I could tell a joke. A vaudeville agent is interviewing acts. A man comes in and says, boy, do I have the act for you. The agent replies, well, what is it you do? The man explains, first of all, my wife and I come out on stage fully nude while eating plates of each other's shit. She's swinging an aborted fetus above her head that we've stuffed with illegal fireworks, which she slings into the audience, aiming for the nearest child as it detonates. I then bring out my daughter on an operating table and DIY amputate every single limb from her body while a surgeon advises me over speakerphone. While that's happening, my youngest son comes flying out dressed as a French maid, strapped to a military drone that slowly hovers over the stage while my wife shoots a dildo machine gun at him. Once he's unconscious from blunt force trauma, we wheel out grandma and feed her into a wood chipper while singing Oh What a Beautiful Morning from Oklahoma. For the finale, I show my unnaturally bulged gut, turn around, and give rectal birth to a dozen live lake trout as they spill into a freshwater tank on the stage, which my wife then drowns our newly limbless daughter inside while I get a blowjob from our HIV-positive family dog. The agent is stunned. That's amazing. What do you call yourselves? And the father replies, cuties! And post! Okay, so as I predicted, I did not magically learn how to laugh again thanks to the beauty of the internet, but I got kind of close, so count that. And that brings me to the actual lesson of the day. Just fake it till you make it. How to fake laugh, realistic.
Hey guys, I'm going to give you a mini tutorial on how to develop a really good fake laugh.
Uh-huh.
You really want to get it from the back of the...
Alright, back of the throat.
So for example, if somebody tells a joke, and that's why I'll never go in aeroplanes. It's a good one. It's a good one. See, that's like a good one.
All right, noted.
That's why I never go in aeroplanes. Like, that one's noticeably fake.
All right, let's practice it.
This man looks like Shaggy and Minecraft Steve at the same time.
School is starting, so I'm back here again. This was the laugh you used with me today, but good video. I fell for it. You're a real actor. I hope you make it in Hollywood. Oh, hey, there we go. I can laugh again. Perfect. Solve that problem. Well, anyway, I'll see you guys next week to laugh it up again on another Internet Comment Etiquette. Good night and Fortnite dance. Fuck!
out.